who wanted to touch the moon. Once upon a time, in a far away land, lived a king called Kotundu. He wanted to do everything by himself. Once, he wanted to find the exact number of leaves on a tree. His minister suggested, "Your Majesty, let us appoint people to do this job." But King Kotundu replied, "No, I have to do it myself." So he started counting the leaves. He had his royal breakfast, lunch, tea, and dinner under the tree. Even the royal bed was placed under the tree. All the business of the court had to be done under the tree. "Your Majesty, the people want your permission to build a dam," said the minister. 5,744 was the only reply. "Your Majesty, our army needs some more weapons," said the commander of the army. 32,999 was all the answer he got. This went on for 6 months. The people didn't know what to do, but King Kotundu would not stop. Luckily, the season changed and the tree shed all its leaves. So, King Kotundu had to stop counting. Once King Kotundu was resting on the terrace, he saw the full moon shining bright in the sky. "How far is it from here to the moon?" King Kotundu asked his minister. "I have no idea, Your Majesty," said the poor minister. "Find out," said the king. "I want to touch the moon." The minister was aghast. "But Your Majesty, how will you reach there?" "You must start building a tower to take me up to it," the minister called a message. But they told the king that such a tall tower was sure to fall. King Kotundu got angry and sent away the message. He thought for a day and then he had an idea. "Build a wooden tower," he ordered, "and use all the wooden boxes in the palace to build it." But of course, there weren't enough boxes in the palace. "Bring all the boxes you can find in the whole kingdom," ordered the king. Thousands of boxes were collected. Many, many boxes were placed one on top of the other. Soon the king couldn't see the top of the tower. "Now," he thought, "the tower is big. I shall go up and touch the moon," the minister said. "Let us send a guard up first to see how tall the tower is, Your Majesty." "No need," said the king. "I shall go up myself first." He began to climb up the tower, higher and higher. The people couldn't see him now, but they soon heard his voice from the sky. "The moon is still far away. Throw some more boxes to me." So they obeyed. After a while, they heard the voice again. "More boxes. The moon is still away." Once again, more boxes were thrown up. "More boxes. More boxes." They heard every little cry. Up went the boxes. 1, 2, 3, 4. More came the orders from above. The boxes went up. And oh, what was that? Suddenly, there was a bang, and a crash, and a thud, and a rumble, and a tumble. The tower began to sway, the crumble. Down came the boxes in 2s and 3s and 8s and 20s. People ran for their lives. Soon there was a mound of tumbled down boxes where there had been a tower. And where was the king? Did the king really touch the moon? No one ever found out. The people never dared to ask, and the king, not a word did he speak about it ever again.